morning.
Good morning.
I wish for you a blessed and happy Sabbath. With me today, in addition to my wife of 43 years, Sharon. She looks startled. When my father was marrying us, he went on a little bit long, and towards the end, when it was time to do the vows, he startled us both by saying, "And you, Kenneth." I think I just did that to my wife. With me also today is my mother and her husband, Robert Drockenberg, Robert and Ellen Drockenberg. I'm glad to have them here.
Amen.
My father passed away 14 years ago, and for my mother to find love again, I think is just an extraordinary thing.
Amen.
My father and Robert were ordained as ministers at the same ceremony. He lost his wife about the same time that my father died. They were able to find love again. So it's nice to have both of you here today. Also here today as a visitor is Ney Ramirez and his wonderful family. Ney is a chaplain at the hospital.
Welcome.
I found him when I was leading Florida Hospital Flagler. He was just coming out of Andrews University and wanting a job as a chaplain, and I was able to snag him. And they were using him part-time at Flagler, and when I moved here, I needed a part-time chaplain, and so we filled him out. He's now full-time and employed at the by the conference, and we just are so blessed by your ministry. May let out in one of the prayers at our National Day of Prayer. And, just did a nice job. May has the gift of relationship. People at the hospital, employees, the patients, just absolutely love him. I'm so grateful that you're here. You brought your family too.
Yes. Glad to be here.
They also came to our Christmas program this year with his family. I have some good pictures of them. It's a good thing. So I greet you this morning in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And it is my prayer that our words today will bring honor and glory to God. That our deeds will bring honor and glory to God. And I would invite you, as we begin, let's approach the throne of the King of the universe one more time and ask for his blessing. Father God, indeed it is a privilege for us to be able to gather together to worship you on this Sabbath day. It is our desire, Lord, that we might be light and salt. We pray, Lord, that you would bless our efforts, that you would send your Spirit to be a part of our worship today, and that it might bring honor and glory to you. To that end, I pray and I thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because of our unique health message, Ellen White and the early pioneers of our church began the ministry of healing that today is known as Adventist Healthcare. Adventist Healthcare, as a work, began in 1866 in Battle Creek, Michigan, when at that time they opened what was known as the Western Health Reform Institute. Nearly 20 of today's hospitals in these United States had their beginnings between 1866 and 1913 Some names that I'm sure you will recognize: St. Helena Hospital, Portland Adventist Medical Center, Walla Walla General, Glendale Adventist Medical Center, Loma Linda University Health. We know it as Medical Center, but they've changed their name to Loma Linda Health. Adventist Medical Center in Hinsdale. The White Memorial Hospital Medical Center, Park Ridge Health, and Florida Hospital. Began in 1908. If you've never heard that story, it's a remarkable story where early church believers, you were there in 1908? No.
Washington Adventist.
Yeah. It's really an amazing legacy that we as a church have as it relates to our medical ministry. Today, if you travel abroad and you are injured or you're sick and you go to one of the U.S. embassies in many of these countries and you ask for help, where could I go to get good help? Most of the time, they're going to send you to the Adventist hospital in that country.
Amen.
Because of the reputation that we enjoy. Over 500 healthcare institutions around the world.
Amen.
And it's an amazing thing that is born out of this unique health message that we have been given. I have three gifts that I'm going to give you today, and the first gift is a book. And by the way, I made sure that you don't get them while we're here worshiping together, because I suspect that you might start leafing through it and tune me out. So we have a controlled gift process here, and the deacons are going to give you your book on your way out. So the first gift is a book called A Legacy of Health and Healing. And I would imagine that you've been doing the math, 1866. That means that last year, we celebrated our 150th anniversary of Adventist Healthcare. And so Adventist Health System, the company that I work for, commissioned this book, and it's really stories of early Adventist healthcare. And I want each family to have a copy of that. I think I have a total of 60 of them, so I think we should be able to have one for everybody, each family. Florida Hospital New Smyrna joined this legacy when on April 1st of last year, it went from Birdfish Medical Center to Florida Hospital New Smyrna. And so we put on that cloak, that legacy, as part of this great Advent healthcare movement that we have. I am drawn to the mission of Adventist Health System. The mission is to extend the healing ministry of Christ. It's a high calling. Jesus sought the good of those to whom he ministered. He didn't have ulterior motives. He sought their good. That text in John 10:10, I have come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. He healed those with diseases. He even raised some from the dead. Or would we like to have that?
Yes.
Wow. He comforted those who mourn. He gave living water to those who were thirsty. He was interested in their health, their whole person, health, body, mind, and spirit. The vision statement of Adventist Health System reads as follows. I haven't memorized this one, so please bear with me. Don't tell my boss. Adventist Health System is widely respected as a consumer-focused organization that engages individuals in their health by delivering Christ-centered, holistic, best practice care across a connected, comprehensive continuum of services. With Christ as our example, Adventist Health System cares for and nurtures people, our employees, our communities, our healthcare professionals, and those who trust us for care and healing. I think it paints a good picture to me of what it is that we should be about. We have developed at Florida Hospital New Smyrna a purpose statement. Our purpose is to honor God through the care we provide in His Son Jesus' name to the community where we find ourselves.
Amen.
Honoring God through the care we provide. It's a high calling. Adventist Health System has, as part of their strategic visioning process, they develop every 5 years a vision statement. We started this in before 2010, and that first vision statement was Vision Statement 2010. And then when that passed, we moved on to Vision Statement 2015, and since that's now passed, we're now working on Vision Statement 2020. I'm not going to read that for you because it's a pretty comprehensive document. Don Jernigan, our former boss, president of Adventist Health System, has retired, and we have a new leader by the name of Terry Shaw. I believe that God has appointed him to lead our organization, and Terry has asked us to memorize the five words associated that he has simplified this vision statement into. Those words are holistic, exceptional, connected, affordable. Not something you hear often in healthcare. And you wonder about our aspirins that we take a lot of heat for what it costs. And then the last word is viable. When you combine the mission statement, extending the healing ministry of Christ, the vision statement that I read, our purpose statement, and these five words, they really do encapsulate what I believe is the sacred work that we have been given. Don Jernigan, before he retired, was known at Adventist Health System for pushing us as leaders within the system to look for, to find, and to go after the intersection of doing good and doing well. I hope that in some of the things that you hear me talk about today, that you can recognize that intersection. As the CEO of the hospital, you can imagine that I get letters from people that we have served, from their families, from people in the community. Just about every day, I get a letter from somebody. Most of them, believe it or not, are positive. I actually value the opportunity letters because they give me some things to work on, some opportunities. There's one letter that I will never forget. Received it several years ago. It was from a lady that was getting ready to have surgery, was admitted to the hospital, and she was nervous about what they were going to find when they opened her up. In her letter, she talks about being anxious and agitated. And then in her letter, she tells me about a housekeeper that was cleaning her room the day before surgery. She happened to be humming a tune, a hymn. The patient recognized the hymn, made a comment to the housekeeper. They struck up a conversation and a friendship. The housekeeper recognized the burden that that dear patient was having, the struggle, the anguish that she was having. And she asked if she might have a word of prayer. The patient said yes. She prayed. The letter focused on that prayer. She didn't talk about the amazing MRI machine or the linear accelerator in our cancer center. She didn't focus on the capital expenditures that make healthcare possible. She talked about that housekeeper. And she said that that prayer was the most significant aspect of her entire stay.
Amen.
The prayer of a hospital. Faith-based healthcare, I believe, is better than any other kind of healthcare.
Amen.
Because we can focus on the whole person. Body, mind, and spirit. And when we recognize that the patient is more than just a gallbladder in room 305, we will be able to accomplish our purpose, honoring God, and fulfilling our mission of extending the healing ministry of Christ. This week, the Lord knew that this would be a perfect time to share it. This week, I received another very memorable letter from the family, three brothers of a patient that we cared for. For HIPAA reasons, I'm not going to share the name. Not a good thing to do. But the letter included a poem that they wrote just for us. Before I share it with you, I need to explain just a little bit of what's going on. You see, we believe that nurses, how many of you here today, by the way, are nurses? Special people. We're going into your week, but in my world, you guys like get the whole year. Nurses are important. My son, my oldest son, is a nurse. He met his lovely wife in nursing school. They have given us two amazing grandchildren. Grandchildren, by the way, are better than children.
Yeah.
They are God's gift for not having killed your kids. Grandchildren are amazing. But so my daughter-in-law and my son are nurses. My sister is a nurse. And we at Florida Hospital New Smyrna decided that we needed to adopt a recognition program for nurses called the DAISY Award. So you'll hear the DAISY Award referenced in this letter, and I thought you should be aware of that. The DAISY Foundation was established in honor of a gentleman that passed away by the name of J. Patrick Barnes. And this letter references Patrick's DAISY Award. Dear Mr. Madison, by the way, the date of the letter is April 26, 2017. This is as fresh as it gets, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
As fresh as it gets. Dear Mr. Madison, our father has been a somewhat regular patient at Florida Hospital New Smyrna, previously known as Burt Fish Medical Center, for many years. On this latest visit, my brothers and I have come to appreciate the much treasured skills of your staff, both professionally and spiritually. Did you get that? Both professionally and spiritually. Body, mind, and spirit. Just as the Daisy Award is a reminder to stop for a moment and think about how special they are, the New Smyrna Beach community is blessed to have what amounts to be a field of daisies at its Florida Hospital, New Smyrna.
Amen.
Amen. I love this letter. Our family extends its deepest heartfelt expression of thankful appreciation to your nursing teams and staff. We will be submitting Daisy Award ballots, but you should know that we hold all who cared for our father these past many days in high esteem. With grateful prayers of thanksgiving for their kind and compassionate service, we now know, and now we're home. What greater gift is this than when in challenged times you meet a friend not known before your illness came, after which you know you're not the same? Not knowing for which way to start, we praise the healing hands which touched our hearts. For within this kind and sheltered place, we've found God's peace, true love, and amazing grace.
Amen.
Isn't that beautiful? And it's a capital G, by the way, on the word God. God's peace, true love, and amazing grace. The nurse's smile is the most reassuring and uplifting medicine one can prescribe for a patient. As visiting friends and families, we extend our heartfelt praise and appreciation to all of you. This place is very special. For the emergency room staff and the fourth floor ICU, the two places where this patient was seen. Be strong, remain true, and stay who you are, the very best.
Amen. Amen.
Honoring God with the care we provide our community, extending the healing ministry of Christ. I believe we achieve that with this faith. And I thank God for that witness. Healthcare in this country is broken.
Amen.
You didn't have to be quite so. But I know it is.
Yeah.
It's broken. When I entered healthcare 41 years ago, man, it seems like just yesterday, 1976, the percentage of the gross domestic national product that was spent on healthcare in this country was around 7%. Today, we're spending just under 17%. Of our gross domestic national product on healthcare. And what are we getting for it? Costs are too high.
Amen.
Quality is not where it needs to be. The health status of the people that we have in our country is not what it should be.
Amen.
No.
We know today that 75 to 80% of the chronic diseases that we treat every day are because of poor choices that we make as human beings. We know that even though an obscure group known as Seventh-day Adventists have been preaching an amazing health ministry for a long time. Is it possible that Adventist health care can have an impact?
Yes.
I believe it is.
Yes.
The story of Esther. I love that story. Mordecai in Esther chapter 4, verse 14 tells Esther, "For such a time as this, God has placed you in a position of responsibility to make a difference."
Yeah.
And I believe that like Esther of old, we have a responsibility to make a difference. So what are we doing? What are our plans for the future? What's going on right now? I want to start by talking a little bit about some specifics at Florida Hospital New Smyrna. It's close to home. It's the hospital I will go to when I get sick. I want it to be a good place. Venetian Bay, that's the closest hospital to Venetian Bay. First, we have gone about focusing on the culture of the organization. I believe that as the leader of the hospital, I have a responsibility to focus on culture. I'm supposed to do a lot of things, but culture is squarely on my desk. I have to focus on a culture of care, quality care, a culture of accountability, culture of compassion. That's the essence, I believe, of faith-based health care. Care that is delivered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I also am focusing right now on upgrading our systems of care. The electronic medical record, some nurses claim it is the bane of all of nursing. Whoever came up with that brilliant idea missed the mark. Because of the complexities of healthcare, an electronic medical record really is an important part of the system that we use, or the systems that we use to properly document and monitor care. This week, on Sunday, 7 days ago, we turned the switch on for our Cerner electronic medical record. And the learning curve for our team has been very steep this year. I try and round through the hospital at least once a day. And I must tell you that our team has paid a high price for what we've thrown at. The first couple of days, a lot of deer in the headlight looks. What have you done to us? Yesterday when I rounded and I asked the question, "So how's it going?" Most people said, "This is better than what we had. I'm able to provide better care because of this. in 1 week. Not everybody's there yet, but they're getting there. This is the electronic medical record that is used in all of the 47